Due to its seemingly exotic qualities and rareness, the pineapple soon became a symbol of hospitality in early America. Because trade routes between America and Caribbean island were often slow, it was considered a significant achievement from a host to procure the ripe pineapple for guests. The pineapple symbol was also used frequently in the 18th and 19th centuries to decorate bedposts, tablecloths, napkins, and anything associated with welcoming guests. Today, the pineapple remains a fitting symbol for the hospitality industry, and pineapple themed products still abound, from lamps to candle holders to salt and pepper shakers and beyond. The pineapple motif says welcome.
The interrelated nature of hospitality and tourism. The hospitality and tourism industry is the largest and fastest growing industry in the world. Under the umbrella of travel and tourism, countless professions are necessary to meet the needs and wants of people away from home. All of these scopes have an effect on each other.
Interrelated nature of hospitality and tourism. Interrelated means connected to each other. It means tourism and hospitality. Each scope affects one another because of their direct relationship. For Intikey's managed services, the food services operation ensures that they satisfy the needs and wants of their guests or customers they serve and deliver.
Hospitality industry has many characteristics, such as intangible service, cannot see and touch but can feel, sales or service owned by the person, but it cannot be opened, from the service providers to service consumer, provide services can be entrusted to the service providers, perishable service, won't last long and won't experience the same experience. For example, service resource allocation, processes and systems to provide services within a certain period. When the service has really given to users of the service request, this particular service irreversibly vanish. Inseparable service means production, and from the customer's experience, because someone must timely produce and the services provided by service providers is essential to provide services.
Simultaneous service means the service is some kind of host and at the same time consumption. As long as the service requirements of service consumers are generated without any delay and friction, and services consumers instant consumption rendered interest for the implementation of his upcoming events or tasks. Variable service is a term that means disposable, generating, rendering, and consumption can never be accurately repeated time points, location, and the case under the condition of the current configuration, information, the allocation of resources is different from the coming up delivery, even is the same kind of service to the same service consumers request.
Shift work in hospitality industry means an employment practice, use of or the provision of service across all 24 hours of the clock each day of the week. Different types of shift include shifts that rotate or change shifts that are split apart by several hours, permanent shift, day or night. Guest satisfaction in hospitality industry means that the guest was satisfied with the service of the employee. Guest satisfaction depends on a hotel service because guests have rising expectation for a hotel, but their overall satisfaction with service is also part of the guest's overall satisfaction in a hotel.
The founders of hospitality industry. Ellsworth Milton started in 1863 to 1928, the father of commercial hotels, started as a bellboy at the age of 13 in Wheeling, West Virginia, then later advanced to hotel clerk, but built his first permanent Statler Hotel in 1907 in Buffalo, New York. He then built hotel branches in Cleveland in 1912, Detroit in 1915, St. Louis 1917, New York 1919, then the last is Boston in 1927. Conrad Nicholson Hilton in 1887 to 1979. Conrad Nicholson Hilton was an American businessman who founded the Hilton Hotel chain from 1912 to 1916. Hilton was a Republican representative in the Hilton, Mexico legislature but became disillusioned with the inside deal of politics. Bought and built hotels throughout Texas, including the high-risk Dollar Hilton, opened in 1925, Abilene Hilton in 1927, Waco Hilton in 1928, and the El Paso Hilton in 1930. Built his first hotel outside of Texas in 1939 in Albuquerque, New Mexico, today known as a Hotel Andalor. J. Willard Marriott and Willard Marriott. J. William Marriott founded the Twin Bridges Marriott Motor Hotel in Arlington, Virginia in 1957. Keybridge Marriott in Arlington, Virginia is Marriott International's longest operating hotels and celebrated its 50th anniversary in 2009. The complete expansion of its worldwide reservation center in Nebraska made it the largest single site reservation operation in the U.S. hotel industry. Cesar Ritz, 1850 to 1918. Cesar Ritz was a hotelier at Grand National Hotel in Lucerne, Switzerland because of his management abilities. Ray Schatz, he founded Hampton in 1980. In 1984, he provided guests with special amenities like free continental breakfast and free phone calls. Jay Pritzker purchased the Hyatt House Hotel in 1957, built the first anteroom hotel, an architectural design wherein the guest room overlooked the lobby from the first floor to the roof. Ernest Anderson and Robert Moore, the origin of brand date back to 1933, when Harvard classmate Ernest Anderson and Robert Moore purchased the Continental Hotel in Cambridge, Massachusetts in 1933, then purchased the Standard Investing Company and made it the company through which they ran their hotels. William Waldorf Astor and John Jacob Astor started as two hotels. One owned by William Waldorf Astor, whose 13-story Waldorf Astor Hotel was opened in 1893, and the other owned by his cousin John Jacob Astor, called at Astoria Hotel, and opened 4 years later in 1897, four stories higher. Waldorf Astoria was the first hotel to offer room service, making a huge impact for the future of hotel industry. The combined Waldorf Astoria became the largest hotel in the world at the same while maintaining the original Waldorf high standard.
The history of hospitality industry dates all the way back to the colonial period in the late 70s. Things have changed quite a bit since then. The hospitality industry has experienced significant development over the years as it has faced world wars, the depression, and various social changes. The industry as we know it today began to take form in the early 1950s and 60s, leading the way for growth into the dynamic industry we know today. Ancient Greece, guests' rights were an established set of conventions that were accepted amongst the different cultures in the Greek world. Ancient Rome, Roman businessmen traveled. Romans were some of the first known to travel for pleasure. Middle Ages, other provided safety, shelter, and food to travelers. As the use of coaches for traveling took hold, traveling became more popular. Inns were typically in private homes, and nobles stayed in monasteries. The New World. As people settled the New World, they brought their own terms for eating and resting places, inns or taverns. The French Revolution, Scoffier and the Brigade System, Boulanger, the father of modern restaurant, sold a soup called Restaurantes or Restore the Body. 18th, Savoy Hotel opened with Cesar Ritz as the general manager. Delmonico's Steakhouse opened in New York City. Travel boom after World War II. Including this is cross-continental travel or transatlantic flights, Eisenhower interstate system. 1960s and beyond, mass tourism, packaged travel, growth in chains, restaurants, and hotels.